some slide about high frequency injection. I have to highlight that in version 5.5 it's not implemented now. We are working on that, but it's good to know that this is available algorithm, and we are working on that because I have already touched this topic. We are focused for sensorless, and this is a sensorless algorithm, and we are going to find additional through the summer disadvantage of this this method. Why we are looking for this kind of solution? It is due to some limitation of sensorless algorithm, because our reconstruction it's working on the back EMF reconstruction, and with zero speed we receive zero back EMF, and from that it's not able recognize nothing. What is the high frequency injection? We have for that a patent, and how it's work. We implement some high frequency to the motor, and looking for the result. Our result, our feedback from the system, it's a current feedback, and through that it's also the current feedback somehow modulated. The modulation which we implement in the voltage, it's somehow modulate through the structure of the motor and through the position of the rotor. For that it's a first definition or request that we have to have some anisotropy, that it's work only with internal permanent magnet structure, and we have to use it. For the low frequency, for the zero speed or very low speed, we have some possibilities how to observe the position. First one, I don't know it. I know only this name, some zero sequence voltage explanation. I am not sure that's some technique which we don't use. And second, it's a high frequency injection, and another one, it's low frequency injection. Our team around 3 or 4 years ago have a look for the solution and recognize that high frequency it's a good solution that's not require additional hardware. It's easy to implement to our library, and the torque which is inside it's quite avoided through the high frequency. I'm not sure. Yes, I have also additional slide. Maybe there is some comment about the frequency. We will implement some oscillating injected test signal, which is rotate around the cycle. This signal, it's a name high frequency, but it's not real high frequency, but for motor it's high frequency, and motor cannot follow this speed, and only stay, and we measure the result from the high frequency. The algorithm is quite complex, and we have to add additional part which is benefit from north-south detection of the magnet, and these two algorithms work together, and we can benefit from these two. Also, there is some simple implementation how to play with these two algorithms, because high frequency it's injection it's only for a low speed. We will apply high frequency injection on the background with state observer. During low speed or zero speed, after some threshold we start up also the standard observer and PLL, and after some additional time for the stabilization, we decide that now it's the good time for the switching, and running with only one algorithm and save CPU for the another application. Similarly, it's when we slow down again after some threshold, we will again activate HFI, and after some threshold, we switch from the state observer plus PLL to HFI, and after again some threshold, we stop the PLL and save time because it's not reliable work with PLL at this speed. That's simple, some hysteresis control of this two algorithm, and some additional slide. It came from the real system. We use two DAC channels, debug outputs, and you see two signals, which is highlight position of the rotor. One is coming from PLL, and second one from HFI. That's this state. It's just in the middle when both algorithm running and reconstruct the position. And you see that result. It's quite similar. Then second slide when we have only PLL because we are running fast and the signal from HFI it's only at the last value because the code it's not running. That's about the signal. We have some incremental build. That's a picture from the step 7. It's quite complex and it's not easy to tune it, but in this case it's good to highlight that we have some areas. First area, it's start with some injected signal which rotate sometimes around the electrical cycle, and there is again some debug signal which is name HFI in debug angle, and you see how it's stabilized, and this is controlled by some PID regulator, and we have to tune it, and you see that after time it's locked to some stable value, which means some angle. Then it's a part with no source detection, which is quite shorter, but with some additional stuff on that. And the last one, it's locking to continuous spinning. That's the shortest part, but again, it contains some PI regulator, which have to be tuned somehow. And this three part, take some time, but usually it's shorter than alignment, and you will see on the next slide. This is a typical approach of the compressor. It is very nice tuned application because you see that this part it's only two periods, and then it's decrease the current. That means that after some alignment, we apply some revamp phase, and through this short time, we are able to lock to the observation of the angle and decrease current to the necessary value. That's very perfect, precise tuned application. But you can observe what is inside. Inside it's first part, which is here, that's alignment, about more than 1 second with 6 ampere, quite high current in this case. Then we have 8 ampere, some open loop startup, very very short startup, but with 8 ampere. And then it's switched to the closed loop, and it's could be the same with HFI. That's a perfect case, and we have a slide for the comparison. And for the comparison, we have some initial part with all three parts, what we have described in a slide before, and this part need only 2 ampere. The injected signal is quite small. and only 200 milliseconds. That's shorter and smaller current. And then it's startup, but this startup, it's coming from the start with field-oriented control. We apply exact angle, and if motor don't move, then we increase the current to the necessary value. We will cover all possibility with the load, without the load, and for that you see that for the start we do FOC with closed loop implement only 4 ampere, which is because it's necessary, not necessary apply 8 ampere like in the case before. And also you can see in this case that there is modulated injected signal, and after some time when we speed up we decide that there is the time that we are running at the reliable speed for the PLL, and then we switch only for the one algorithm. Yeah, there is without HFI. What is the benefit? The maximal efficiency, because we apply only necessary current, and fast acceleration, because we know that rotor is smooth. That's the goal of a sensorless zero-speed algorithm, and that's all from this part.